Ho imai, all over Mobera Molokai, I will return. Come on, Chino Shimmy, give him up that hill, man.
The day after our team of 16 arrived in Molokai, we left for a 3.5 mile hike down to Kalapapa on the world's biggest sea cliffs. Kalapapa is Molokai's old leper colony, and it was the most beautiful place I've ever seen. You would look up and see waterfalls and beautiful mountains, and it looked like you were really in a scene from Jurassic Park. The 4 days down there, we spent all day volunteering with local park scientists helping to preserve native Hawaiian plants. It was such an amazing experience to see all the history of Kalapapa and learning about the ignorance of Hansen's disease and the things that Father Damien did for the people down there. I will never forget the things I learned, the time that we spent there, and all of the beautiful things I got to see.
I will return. I will return. I like the gecko singing in the night.
So to come there and do what we did, it just really made them feel like people do care. And so after we spent 4 days on Kalapapa, we hiked back up the 3.5 mile back up. It was really hard. And we spent the week volunteering at local churches. We cleaned the highways, we picked up rubbish, and did some local just outreaches. But the most important thing that we did was we put on Molokai's first skate contest. And it's actually really cool because Surfing the Nations built the skate park 2 years ago that we put the contest on at. And so to come there and bring our whole crew and bring some pretty professional people to come and put the skate contest on, and we had prizes like everything from skateboards to iPods, and we gave away food from the Hawaii Food Bank to families that really needed it. And it was just such a blessing, and so going there really changed my perception of like how much of a big difference can I make doing a skate contest in the state of Hawaii for these kids. But we really saw just God use it, and the kids were so stoked and so blown away, like getting iPods and like getting like skateboard decks. And I gave away a skateboard that my dad gave to me before I left. Dad, I didn't tell you that, but I gave it to a kid in Molokai, and you just saw how blessed it was, and they were just like, when are you coming back? Like, what day are you coming back? Like, they're so stoked, and I hope that you guys can see that we couldn't have done it without you, and I couldn't have been able to experience this without you. So this next part of the video will just show you some of the stuff we got to do, some water time, just skating, the skate contest, and I hope you see just the joy in the kids' faces and know that they did hear about the God who loves them so much. And I hope you can see just the effect that it really had on the people there.
Thank you. biggest dreams of my lifetime. Pools of fascination in my sleep.
Molokai, I've just been finishing out my internship, and I've been working on the Freedom Surf Contest for Surfing the Nations, which is super cool because it's just an awesome contest. It's a really big contest on Mother's Day weekend in Waikiki, right at Queens. And so it's just a great opportunity to just outreach into the community, and for me to be a part of it is like such a blessing because it's what I love, is working through surfing and the surf industry and stuff. And I graduate April 22nd. So that's like next week. So pray for me that I pass all my tests and that I'm making a year commitment here. So I'll be full-time ministry here at Surfing the Nations for a year. And most importantly, I'm going to Bali on July 3rd. And I really wanted to let you guys know about that because this is the first time that I'm in full-time ministry where I can't have a job and help raise my own money. So I really am depending on the Lord and really depending on the support that I have from you guys at home. And it's just so exciting to see God continue to speak into my life about my future there. And it's another reason why I'm committing to a year here, because I want to go through just a really good discipleship training before I'm sent out. And I know that God wants me to do that and take time to really grow until I'm fully ready to be full-time in Indonesia. But I definitely still believe that's where God is calling me. So I'm really excited about going back in July. I know that God's going to do some crazy, awesome things with the relationships there that I already have. I know that God's just put a heavy weight on my heart for them, and so I'm still studying Indonesian, and I'm just fully dependent on your support to get me there this year. And I hope that you guys can partner with me, because you're really investing in the future too, and especially for me, as I desire just to be there full-time eventually. And so this trip is just really important to me, and it's really special to me. And I just thank you so much for the support that I've already had to be there. And just, I just want you guys to prayerfully consider just sending in some support for this trip, and just believing for the Balinese people and the Indonesian people to come to know the Lord. And yeah, I just want you guys to know that I love you so much and miss you, and thank you so much for everything you do, and just the prayer and the care and the love that I have from you guys. So, thanks. And I want to say hi to my mom and dad and to my church. I love you guys. So.
Moisturizing me to satisfaction. In my imagination alone. He's pouring out his soul to me for hours and hours, drawing out my nature with his hands, yearning, I'm so thirsty for his power, burning to be worthy of his land.